everything, right? In life, people emulate the end result, not the process. The end result is what they see, and they emulate that.
Hi, I'm Joe James, veteran turned actor.
I put my life on the line more than once to protect your name. Come on, is this all you can do? Is this all you can do to protect mine?
Yes! Did you feel the difference? You saw, you were talking, there was life. That was so good.
It's like, you know, this went, these free throws. Before Kobe scored that 61, that day.
You were there?
That day. That day he was practicing. He practiced his whole life. Are you willing to put in that sort of commitment?
So I'm from South Carolina. I was in the military for 6 years. I've been acting for 2.5 years, and it's been a crazy journey so far.
Oftentimes, as people, we forget about the process of going through things. We glorify the end result, but then we're like, what happened in between? So I'm taking you guys in between, and we're starting out with Joe James.
How I got started in acting is I got injured in the military and having to leave early. I wanted to chase my next dream, so I researched and found an agent, which was a little bit of a process and had to go through some training. And then once I got with the agent, my first booking was with Aaron's Furniture commercial.
So we know who you are now. You are a veteran turned actor.
Yes.
And you started out doing a furniture commercial, yes. Which is very cool. And you said it only took you, what, 2 weeks?
2 weeks, yeah.
That's kind of crazy. It takes actors sometimes like a lifetime to get a national commercial. How did it feel when you like first got that commercial?
I mean, honestly, I was just blown away because, you know, I have no formal training in this. It was just a heartfelt passion and dream. Once one ended, I chased the next one, and I was just blessed to be right place, right time.
Nice. So what did you do in that commercial?
In that commercial, just did a lot of smiling, a lot of handshaking. You know, I had my TV wife. Shout out to you, Jasmine. Yeah, you know, they had to do a couple different scenes, like laying on the couch, pretending she's asleep, inside the store shopping, and at home, moving into our new place, dancing around. So,
So I know, like, with sometimes there are big productions and there are smaller productions. So was this like a small set feel, or was it like a gigantic set, and you were like overwhelmed, or like, oh my god? This is my first time. They don't know that, but
no, it was a small set. You know, I mean, big production, but small set because working in limited spaces. So a lot of the actual performances were just 2 and 3 of us on the set at a time. So They kept it intimate, and you know, the great things about commercial is just you have fun. There's no real right or wrong. You just be loose, be natural, and have fun.
Okay. Very, very, very cool. I'm glad that you got that experience. So you said, okay, you said you got injured as a veteran, and then you just up and decided like, let me look up careers. I want to be an actor. Is that what happened, or is this something that's like started in childhood? How did that come about?
Well, honestly, it's something that started in childhood. Okay. But you know, coming from, you know, a poor family, to be blunt, poor family, small town, it didn't really seem like something that I could achieve. But at the time when I got hurt, I joined the military late. So I worked a ton of jobs before going in. And what a lot of people don't know is they put us through these courses where to help you prepare to get out and move back into the civilian world. And listening to a lot of folks tell their stories or their uncertainties of what they wanted to do, I didn't want to have that uncertainty in my life. So I knew it was a dream, and that I'll be set up in a manner that I can chase it without too much worry. So, you know, I just put all my heart, mind, and soul into it.
Do you use any of your techniques from, does any of it cross over, like the skill set from your military, or is it military? Okay, your military background to the acting world?
Absolutely. You know, in the military, for a lot of people, it could be a bit of a culture shock because you're dealing with folks from all around the world who join, and then the military takes you all around the world to meeting different people on the civilian side once again. So it's the same thing in acting. You know, it's a universal dream for a lot of folks. And once you make it to that set and having all those experiences, it made it that much easier to dive into those characters that was going out for us.
Let's see, what else? It's like you want to say something after you say that question. What is it that you're trying to say? Because you want to say something, but you're stopping yourself because you're married to the words.
Hi, my name is Raquel John, and I am an actress, a painter, and the founder and CEO of Purposely You.
Well, it's because part of me is like, don't really want to let it, let too much out, because like, the desk duty is good as saying I'm guilty, and the guilty ain't just losing my job, I'm going to jail. So like, it's there, but like, I don't want to snap off and still be in the same position. It's like,
I'm sorry, go ahead.
I'm angry, but I'm trying to keep it under control so I can manipulate the captain to let me off the hook, to help me out.
Okay, I need you to relax though too. Cause I feel like you're trying to confine yourself a little bit. Mm-hmm. And I know it's hard to do the technical parts and still be free, but it's possible. Mm-hmm.
I'm a teacher, I'm an acting coach as well. I started that back in April, actually. I kind of stumbled into that as well. That was an opportunity brought by a long friend of mine and this lovely woman named Angela Davis, who's an amazing actor as well as an acting coach. And so I teach with her and it's been great. I am learning tons of stuff. And so I'm honestly grateful and honored to be an acting coach.
So like this one, since this is like since we got one more of this one, free yourself. What do you feel? You know the words, you know, you get it, you understand it. What do you feel? Add a word if you want to add a word. Make it yours. Feel comfortable, because you have to feel comfortable and relaxed. Even in an intense scene, you have to feel it. Like, you need to feel like, this is it, I'm about to lose everything. That's how you have to feel. Think of a time in your real life where you're like, close to like, am I about to lose everything? And feel that. And substitute. Oh, okay. Uncomfortable?
Mm-hmm.
Are you uncomfortable? A little bit. Good. Is it?
No, not really. I'm remembering a very particular situation where that happened.
Use it.
Alright, you ready?
Did you need me back at the...
Yeah, just take one step.
Going for a take. Quiet on set.
Well, the most effective acting technique is to just be free. To be you. Without the foundation of self, you can never really ever put yourself in someone else's shoes. And a lot of times, as human beings, as our human experience, our traumas tend to block us from even us discovering who we are. And with the ability of breaking that mold and just being free within self, you can be this phenomenal actor that can take on multiple types of characters because you have okayed yourself to be yourself. And a lot of times with society and human experience and, like I said, life and childhood traumas, we don't okay ourselves. And that's why we have so many blocks. But once you okay who you are, get to know who you are, live in that first, that, I would say, will really unlock things for you as an actor.
Cut it.
I like that take.
I probably got what you were talking about.
You probably got what you want. I was like,
one more, we're good.
Let's free, whatever you feel.
Free porn?
Yeah, just...
Do it for love.
We know how you started. What has it been like thus far? You've been doing it for 2 years now. Have you had any like moments where you wanted to give up or moments that stand out in your head that you're like, man, I wish I could have done this differently, or?
Definitely moments where I wish I'd done something differently, but never a moment of wanting to give up. Mm-hmm. I mean, anything you do is going to come with an obstacle. So the real question is just how bad do you want it?
Mm.
So I always just, you know, push myself. So if there's a problem, then I just need to figure out the solution of how to get over the obstacle.
Mm.
But yeah, you know.
Oof, that's different for me. That's different because I'll be like, maybe God is trying to tell me to be done with this and try something else. But I always find myself coming back to it. So even though I do have moments where I'm like, maybe I should just quit. Like, maybe this isn't for me. Somehow I always get back into it. So that's encouraging. And that also shows different actors. Like, everybody has their different moments too.
Yeah.
For you, it's like, I'm never giving up. Like, there's no doubt in your mind. For me, it's like, sometimes I'm like, and then I'm back.
What I would suggest, I mean, for you and anybody out there, is use that doubt as fuel. You know, again, it's because if you really want something, like
that's
if you wanted that car, you wanted that job, you wanted that house, that certain pocketbook, those shoes, you're going to find a way to get it. Like,
mm-hmm.
nothing's going to stop you. So it's no different with the acting. It's just, you have to understand it is a business,
mm-hmm.
and you can't take things personal, because our whole career is based off of our emotions.
Mm.
So, you know, again, use that that doubt and that fear or that rejection to just fuel yourself to go beyond, because there's, like you said earlier, there's no one way. There's no
mm-hmm.
right way. Everybody has a different path getting into this career.
Very, very, very true. I hope your day is going well.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like we just came in like, get it.
Oh, yeah, I already know what time it is.
Germany. I'm a local Atlanta artist. I'm a photographer, videographer, graphic designer, you name it. I've been doing that for about, I'm gonna say 10 years now. I started in high school, and then I've been adding to my portfolio.
Smile, not your eyes.
Oh, right.
Raise your
eyebrows. Oh,
God.
Stop smiling. And I still think do it.
Does it work, though?
I can do it.
Do it one more time.
It's obviously you.
I'm trying to tell a story or tell the emotion. I'm trying to portray the emotion that whoever my muse is feeling. I actually have an interest in film, so I look for those moments that might come off as a storytelling moment in the film.
Yeah, I want you to take it. So you're gonna take a step back, but with this one, you're gonna kind of be walking towards me.
Give him a point.
So, yeah, take a couple natural steps back and forth. So, like, you're actually walking towards me right now. If you walk on the street.
There's a sense of fulfillment I get in creating anything.
Mm-hmm.
So essentially, that's what continues to motivate me. That creative urge, that it fills me with light. And I feel like I become my best, therefore I be my best to everyone else. And so I feel like I'm doing my part by being my best.
Yeah, we need to see some fear. Like, how do you show your sexy face? Like, wait, I picture me doing that. Oh, God. Okay. That was given axe on the back.
So, you're going to have...
Okay, so my next question would be, so how did it feel, because you were signed to an agent, how did it feel when you first got signed to an agency?
I mean, I was ecstatic. Like, I couldn't, I was jumping off the wall and telling my people and You know, it's something that I had dreamed about for so long. And now that the moment had finally arrived, you know, I was just ready to go. Just, you know, chase the world.
And so, how did it feel when you had to drop your agency?
It was bittersweet. But again, you can never take things in this business personal. Like, it was a professional move. Mm-hmm. Because they are based in Texas, and the Midwest was their market. Mm-hmm. They didn't really have a foothold over here on the Southeast. Mm-hmm. So when I dropped them, it was time to move on and focus on an agency here that can help me progress the career further.
What are you looking for in an agency?
What I'm looking for in an agency is communication. To me, that's the most important. We have to be on the same page of what my goals are and what their goals are. Mm-hmm. And somebody with, you know, structure, proper manpower to handle their clientele, because I don't want to get lost in the mix of all their talent. Mm-hmm. I want to be able to, again, have more of a focus. Because especially now with so many streaming platforms out there and so many productions going up, so many of our younger and older actor veterans ahead of us, they're giving us a lot of opportunities for us to go further.
That is very true. So what's next for you?
What's next for me is, you know, I'm working hard on the indie scene. Have a new sketch comedy show that we're trying to get picked up. I know you hear that. Netflix, Amazon, Hulu, anybody?
What's it called?
It's called It's Variety. You can find it on YouTube, and you can follow It's Variety Network on Instagram, and It's Variety on any of the social media platforms. And outside of that, you know, I'm in the market for a new agent in the Southeast.
All right.
So we're pushing for that, and you know, I'm trying to get busy.
Awesome. Well, thank you for talking with me. So now we are going to go on a journey with Joe, and we're going to follow him as he goes through the process of working on his acting portfolio. So we'll see y'all in a little second.
See y'all in the process.
Cool.
Captain, we need to talk. Look, you know I ain't had nothing to do with that shooting in the Heights. Come on, if I knew anything, you'd be the first to know. Come on, you really gonna put me on desk duty? Look, after everything I've done for this department, after everything I've done for you, I put my life on the line more than once to protect your name. Come on, is this all you can do? Is this all you can do to protect mine? So, son, I want to talk to you about what you thought you saw. First of all, your mother's not upset with me, okay? Those were tears of joy. And, you know, like sometimes you cry, like on your birthday when you finally got that game, yeah? Well, your mother finally got something she wanted. And she was so happy, and that's why she was crying. And you know, like when you and Mikey wrestle? Well, that's one of your mother's favorite things to do as well. And, you know, it's her favorite pastime. And you saw her enjoying something she likes to do because she's been a good girl. And you get what I'm saying? Hey, Ma.
You may not understand
why I'm doing this. But it's the best decision for the both of us. He's seen you like this. I trust you to take your meds, and I'm not always around to make sure these things get done. We knew the cop that came to the house this time, but next time, we may not be so lucky. Love you. But I can't take care of you anymore. I'm selling the house. This place is going to be your home. They're going to take such good care of you. You lived your life. I gotta live mine.
Such an eventful day. Shout out to MonA for throwing this amazing thing together. The monologues performed today, the photo shoot done today, the outfits were just absolutely amazing. It was quick, professional, clean. We had a lot of fun behind the scenes, as y'all gonna see, and in front of the camera. So, I mean, shout out to everybody working on production. Shout out to CL, shout out to Shalom, shout out to Chris, shout out to everybody, man. It was just a phenomenal day. So, yeah, appreciate it. Hope y'all enjoyed. And let's get some more episodes in, man. Hit up MonA and let's keep this thing going.
Cut.
That's cut.
One take home.